In this video, we're taking a look at the Event Horizon challenge on HackTheBox, and this is a forensics challenge in the easy category. So we can see the description says our CEO's computer was compromised in a phishing attack. The attackers took care to clear the PowerShell logs, so we don't know what they executed. Can you help us? So let's download the files. And we have a logs folder and a trace format folder. Let's copy these into our local directory. Put in our password, HackTheBox. And let's see what's in these folders. So if we have a look here, run tree, we get a list of all the files that are in those directories. It looks like the trace format is empty. We have two directories, 323 files. Let's list the trace format. You can see, yep, nothing in there. Everything's inside the logs. And these are all event logs. So if you go into the logs and check the file types, we can see here MS Windows Vista, entry log, and some additional information about some of these. So one thing we could do to begin with, just in case there's an easy win, we could say, let's get the strings, all strings that are above 10 from every file. And we could then say, let's grep out anything that has, flag, HTB in it. Nothing for us. What about if we just try to grep out the curly brace in case maybe there's been some rot 13 or something done on the HackTheBox? So it doesn't appear to be anything useful unless we have it buried in here somewhere, but I can't see anything sticking out. So if we go back to our HackTheBox, we can see that they gave us a hint and said the attackers took care to clear the PowerShell logs, so we don't know what was executed. So let's try and ls grep PowerShell, grep PowerShell, nothing there, okay. Let's try just power, and there we go, capital P. So we have these PowerShell event logs, we have admin, operational, and then this Windows PowerShell. So these are some, we may want to look into these. Let's, if we try to cat that out, okay, make sure we deal with the space, cat that out, and you can see that there's a lot of unrecognized characters here, which makes it a little bit hard to work out. Quite hard to work out what's going on. One thing we can instantly spot here is that Mimikatz is used through the PowerSploit library. So a clear indicator of malicious activity right away. NT authority system here. Hidden blue teamer. Alright, so there's some stuff going on. But we want to, and here's another PowerShell file with kind of an obfuscated name. But we want to try and get a better view of this, and if we go to our logs and try to open one of these, we'll get it to say that this file is of unknown type. So we're dealing with a Windows problem. Let's move over to Windows. I'm going to open up Commando here, the Commando VM, which is just a VM which has been like pre-installed with a lot of useful tools. Get an idea of the tools that are installed here if we try to update. This is released by Mandiant, and it's basically designed as like a Windows equivalent of Kali Linux. Has a lot of tools built in. It's very easy to install and update packages. And whenever it sets itself up, it removes and, you know, it makes any changes to the Windows settings and configurations and programs that are needed to basically set up a good pen testing VM. So I think there is a version for like a malware analysis version as well. But I just basically installed a lot of tools on here to help with forensics and malware analysis. Which you'll see in these tools sections. So we can go into different categories, password attacks, evasion, debuggers, etc. So it's a handy operating system. I'd recommend getting it set up if you don't already have a good Windows VM for doing CTF challenges on. But we've copied over the Event Horizon folder here, so let's close down our box starter and let's have a look at the logs. So first thing here is let's search for PowerShell. And we have our event logs here. Let's just check the the default one, PowerShell, first of all. See, it's only 68 kilobytes. In fact, these are all 68 kilobytes apart from this PowerShell operational, which is 5 megabytes. So it's likely that's going to be of more interest to us. You can see I've opened this with the event viewer, but there are some alternatives. Let me see what I actually have here available. Tools. Or maybe in the full tools section. And all right, maybe that's all. I thought we had an event log explorer application as well, but we don't really need it. We've got our default event viewer. This is what is used in Windows. Let's see what we've got in here. So zero events in our Windows PowerShell log, and we know that the other logs here are the same size, so let's not even bother with them. Let's just go straight to our operational PowerShell log. And if we open this up, we can see straight away now we have number of events is 149. It's taking a little bit of time to load, but here we go. We have a download string here where it was grabbing a PowerShell file. Let's just see, out of interest, let's go to this GitHub and let's see what this is referring to. Take our quotes out. Okay, so this is the invoke Mimikatz. Let's see what else is going on here. We have another warning. It's information. Okay, warning. And we have the PowerShell download string. Is this the same file? Yep, it's the same one. Okay. And the same here again. Nothing down there in the user data. Okay, these are all looking very similar. In this case, we have, it's just running invoke all checks. This is a blue team pathway. Let's take a look at this. Okay, we missed the quotes there. All right, not finding that at all. Okay, maybe that's been removed. What else do we have? We have what looks like an encoded string here. You can see it's base64 from strings, so let's copy this and let's go to CyberChef. Let's paste this in here and let's go from base64. You can see here it's given us some code, but doesn't look particularly interesting. What else do we have? Is this the same command here? CM. Nope, this looks like a new base64 encoded string, so let's check that one out. Okay, out file UAC bypass test.txt. What else do we have in a script? Okay. Don't see anything else of interest there. Let's keep going through. We have another script block here. A lot of text to decode. Is this still base64 encoded? Let's try and run magic on it. Okay, magic doesn't seem to really know what to do with it. So let's go back to our event viewer. We have a lot of these script block texts, so let's go to the first one. Author Harmjoy, power up. Okay, so this is power up. Oh, and what do we have here? It looks like a flag. All right, so we see our flag in the PowerShell command here. And I guess that's this challenge solved. We didn't need to decode too much of what was going on with the PowerShell commands here. We can see another as well. If you keep going through the logs, we can see our flag is here as well. And yeah, that's been the, what's the challenge called? Event Horizon. That's been the Event Horizon challenge. I hope you've enjoyed this. Any questions or comments, as ever, leave them down below. Thanks.